I'm on a quintessential corner in Bucktown. On the four corners, you see the old storefronts. You can imagine once upon a time, the butcher, the tailor, the candy shop, all lining these corners. The neighborhood has changed, but these are still here. Many of them turned to residential. And right down here, there's one that was, we believe, once a furniture store, now turned into a residence. Over the course of quite a bit of time, it has evolved into what it is today. The front has a row of small windows on it, so you'd imagine it's pretty dark inside, but wait till you see what we actually have when we get in there. Brad Lippitz is the agent selling this for your brother, right? Mm-hmm. So you know the property well. And one of the great things about it is it's so wide inside.
Yeah, what's great about a former storefront, Dennis, is that it's built lot line to lot line. You get a width and a breadth that's totally unexperienced in Chicago on a standard lot.
That's a wonderful thing. Another thing that is unexperienced we've got to talk about is this great mix of materials. We've got tin roof, modern light fixtures, it's a
real
mix.
What I think is really exciting about this space is that it defies all convention. It combines historical elements, there's nothing exclusively vintage, exclusively modern. It's this dynamic, creative energy that comes together.
Which also means I can furnish it whatever way I want.
Any way you want.
And above us, I mentioned the tin ceiling and the light fixtures, but what they surround is the real capstone of this room, this beautiful pop-up with the skylights and the beams in it.
It's really sensational. You have this glass ceiling looking straight up into the sky. It's incredible.
Yeah. Pouring daylight down on us. Right. Today is a really beautiful day, but I would think on any day.
On any day, it's incredible.
It's great.
It's joyous.
And then we've got the original, it looks like original storefront flooring.
Yeah, this huge front room is the original storefront flooring. You have the original brick from the storefront, the original tin ceiling.
That's cool. And a lot of space. You referred to it as a huge front room. This is a big room. I could subdivide it, couldn't I?
You could. You could put five bedrooms here if you wanted. I mean, the space
is not all in this room, in the building.
In the whole thing. It's an incredibly flexible, fun, energetic space that can be tailored to suit your needs.
That energy extends here to the rear part of the building. Right now, this is configured as a really nice dining nook, family room area here, a study there. The kitchen is behind me, and we'll talk about that. But you could reconfigure this. On the way from the front to the back, we passed one bedroom. There's another bedroom above that we'll get to, but it's possible to steal some of this space in the front or the back, create another bedroom. It's possible to make a big dining room here, the glamour room as Brad described it. You could do all sorts of things to harness the energy that's in here. We've got a lot of daylight here. It's not the same, that glass ceiling that's in the front. There are skylights throughout. So then behind me, we've got the kitchen. It's got a real theatrical feel because it's raised. That has something to do with the original configuration of the building when it was a furniture store or warehouse. But it's very nice. It's up where, you know, you can cook with some drama, and you've got all the commercial grade appliances you might need to do that sort of thing. So then above on the other side is the master bedroom, which is an open space. It has partial walls so that it looks out over this space I'm in. Bathroom has a sauna and a walk-in shower, very nice, and then spiral stairs from there up to a rooftop deck. It's enclosed. Right now, not the greenest because it's early spring, but you can really see entertaining up there and having people spill all the way down through the property because you can have a lot of fun here. You might even have a jam session. Hit it, Brad.